Hey guys, I switched to a thinner oil on a 14-year-old car with over 200,000 plus kilometers on the engine. I went from 5W30 to 0W20. Now, why did I do this? Well, why not? I was curious to see the pros and cons. Of course, it isn't possible to test with 100% accuracy as there can be so many variables. I tested during the same time of the year. I had a new oil filter, new air filter, and this was all local driving to similar destinations. The only reason I switched from Total to Havoline was because I got it cheaper due to a promotion. Price-wise, both these oils are at the bottom end for synthetic oils. They're priced similar. Let's get to the figures. From November 2022 to Feb 23, on the 5W30 oil, I traveled just under 4,100 kilometers. I consumed around 298 liters of fuel, and that gave me an average of 13.69 kilometers per liter. Now, between November 23 to Feb 24, I switched to 0W20, and I traveled just over 4,000 kilometers, and I got an average of 14.89 kilometers per liter. So on the thinner oil, I got around 1.2% more kilometers for the liter. I did notice the car warmed up faster, but only by a bit. With pricing of 5W30 and 0W20 oils being pretty much the same, there's definitely some saving to be had here. I did change the 0W20 oil early after crossing 4,000 kilometers because I was consuming more oil. This engine has always been on 5W30 as recommended by Honda. There obviously would be wear and tear after all this time, and I regularly pushed the engine hard, so I wasn't really surprised that I got consumption. I consumed around half a liter of oil in these 4,000 kilometers. With the 5W30, I only burn around 200 to 300 milliliters of oil between the regular changes of 5 to 6,000 kilometers, which usually I do in around 6 to 7 months. Now, there are a few things I would like to point out as I finalize this. Firstly, stick to what the manufacturer states. Just keep it simple. Secondly, on older engines, more so if you're burning oil, do not go to a thinner oil. If you start burning more oil getting into the combustion chamber, this isn't good for your oxygen sensor and your catalytic converter. If you track your car, you push your engine hard a lot, then in my opinion, you can go one grade thicker. Thirdly, should we strictly follow the manufacturer recommendation? It's no secret that vehicle manufacturers are switching to thinner oils to meet stricter emission standards, plus engines have tighter tolerances now. And of course, to improve fuel mileage, which customers want. A lot of engine wear happens on a cold start, so thinner oils are better from that perspective. But what about long term? There's a video by Project Farm. Love the testing he does. I will leave a link to the video in the comments. He tested four different engine oils from 0W16 to 5W30. I would say it's conclusive enough to say that thinner oils may cause more wear to your engine internals. But does it matter? How much wear and tear are we talking about? If you're holding onto your car longer, maybe it's better to use a slightly thicker oil. I don't know, that's for you to decide. As for me, I've already switched back to 5W30. A 0W30 oil would be the best of both worlds in my situation, but this oil grade isn't common, and those companies that do sell it, it's at a heavier price. I hope you found this video useful. Please consider subscribing and liking. Thanks for watching.